DK Metcalf leading the way. That's not necessarily a surprise when we're looking at Nick Shook's top 10 deep threats in the NFL through 5 weeks. Bit of a surprise, though, to see a pair of rookies ahead of Tyreek Hill as we welcome in Nick joining the program here from around the NFL. What's up, Nick? Always glad to have you here. One of our favorite segments of the week. But first, you must explain yourself behind Tyreek Hill falling outside of the top five all the way down to number 8 on your top 10 deep threats. What's going on there?
So this is something that we covered a little bit a few weeks ago with Patrick Mahomes and our deep passer rankings. And really, it's a product of the Chiefs just simply not going deep as much. Patrick Mahomes' deep pass attempt percentage is the lowest of his career at 11.4%. His air yards per attempt are also the lowest of his career. And the majority of Tyreek Hill's targets are inside 20 yards, which kind of mirrors Patrick Mahomes' passing chart as well. Now, having said that, Tyreek Hill is still very good in the deep passing game. He's got 137 yards on deep receptions and 2 touchdowns. And overall, you know, he's still good everywhere else as well. He joined Jerry Rice as the only receivers with 35-plus receiving touchdowns and 5-plus rushing touchdowns in their career. And he's also got a touchdown from scrimmage in 5 straight games for the first time in his career. So it looks different. But Tyreek Hill is still a great contributor. When we're talking statistically, he's just not quite up there this season right now.
Yeah, and they've got the Bills, of course, this week. Would love to get downfield against that defense here. So it's volume, not value, for Tyreek Hill in the deep passing game. I gotcha. All right, let's move on to some of your top three here, starting with Calvin Ridley, who's had a string of 100-yard receiving games this season. What has he done to get free deep down the field?
Yeah, he's actually had 4 100-yard receiving games, which is the most in the NFL. And even though the Falcons are 0-5, Calvin Ridley has still found plenty of space to flourish, especially without Julio Jones entirely available. He leads the NFL in total deep targets with 16, which kind of proves that Matt Ryan trusts him deep. On those 16 deep targets, he's got 7 receptions, 201 yards, which is 2nd most in the NFL. He's got a touchdown on deep targets as well, and he's averaging 28.7 yards per deep reception. Now, he's doing it in a pretty even distribution between 2 key routes, go and corner routes. His yards gained on each route are almost even. And Matt Ryan, when going deep to Calvin Ridley, has a passer rating of 111.5. So it's proving to be lucrative, even if the Falcons can't quite, you know, get in the win column so far.
Might be underreported or underappreciated, but it is not by Michael Gallup in the Dallas Cowboys. It is not underappreciated by the Cowboys. If you watch that game against the Giants, you know why Michael Gallup is number 2 on your top 10 deep threat list here. How effective has he been in the deep passing game right now?
Very effective. And, you know, I've gotten some gripes from fantasy owners who think that he hasn't been as productive as they wanted him to be. Well, that's your fault for drafting a receiver who's part of a receiving core that also includes Amari Cooper and CD Lamb. But Michael Gallup's been really effective in the deep passing game, as you said. He leads the NFL in total go routes with 71, so it's very clear how the Cowboys want to use him, which is going directly deep. He's 3rd in the NFL in yards gained on deep receptions. 190 yards is the total there, and all of those have been gained on go routes and on just 5 receptions, 9 total deep targets. And the change at quarterback shouldn't affect him because, as you said, that big play, that came on a pass from Andy Dalton, not Dak Prescott, who said afterward, you just got to put it up anywhere close to him, he's going to come down and get it. He got that one last week, and that led to a win. So, you know, it's not producing all the fantasy points you want, but it's still pretty productive.
And the Cardinals' defense has been pretty stingy in the pass game thus far. 4th fewest passing yards allowed per game, and they're without Chandler Jones this week. So maybe a little extra time for Andy Dalton to sit back there and toss it deep to Michael Gallup. Number 1 on your list, I mean, no surprise, the connection between Russell Wilson and DK Metcalf, unparalleled in the NFL thus far. We saw it on Sunday night in the game-winning drive. Give me the goods on DK Metcalf and going deep right now.
So to paraphrase the great Marshawn Lynch, if you've watched any of the Seahawks games in a weekly or near-weekly basis, you know why he's here.
Yeah.
DK Metcalf has become a key receiver in Seattle at all levels of the field, but especially going deep. He's the best in the NFL in that regard. He leads the league in deep reception yards with 296. We just talked about Calvin Ridley, right? 2nd in the league at 201 yards. That's a 95-yard difference on the same amount of deep receptions, which is 7. He has 3 touchdowns on 12 deep targets, which means that every time one out of 4 times Russell Wilson goes deep, he's throwing a touchdown to DK Metcalf. That's some pretty good efficiency there. And he would have had a 4th if he didn't fumble that pass against the Cowboys. But again, right, like you said, that long reception on 4th and 10 really proved how effective he can be catching a deep pass in a key moment and then catching a short pass for a touchdown to win the game. So far, it's producing wonders for the Seahawks.
Yeah, especially when everyone knows it's coming on 4th and long. You know, right, that Russ is looking for DK Metcalf.